Good morning, students. I am Poonrali. I am going to handle biology subject for you. Before getting into the lesson, let us discuss about biology first. So, what is biology? Biology indicates a living thing. Bio indicates a living thing. Logy means to study. Biology is the study of all living things in the universe. See, his name is Aristotle. He is the father of biology. Biology includes two subdivisions. The plants are otherwise called as flora, and the animals are otherwise called as fauna. The study of flora is botany, and the study of zoology, study of animals, that is fauna, is called zoology. The study of both the fauna as well as the flora is called biology. It means what? The study of plants and animals is called biology. In this picture, you may see animals, plants and trees. So we are going to study about this. So this is called biology. So what are living things? Living things are the things which can grow, move, breathe and reproduce. That is called living things. Hope you know these things. Example, plants, animals and human beings. This is a plant, right? Do plants grow? Yes. Do plants breathe? Yes. Do plants reproduce? Yes. Then plants are said to be a living thing. So what is non-living thing then? Non-living things are the things which cannot grow, move, breathe and reproduce. Those are called non-living things. Examples, furniture, phone, pen, table, etc. Okay. What is this? This is a pen. Do the pen breathe? No. Do the pen reproduce? No. Do the pen move? Yes, of course. But if we used to, if we make that move, it will move. Okay. So, then the pen is said to be a non-living thing. Okay. Coming to organisms. What is organism? Organisms are the cells that forms living things. Cells form living things, right? Cells are made up of components that help living things to eat, respire, excrete the waste and perform all the necessary functions in the life. People may say that things ellam organize panni vaiye, arrange panni vaiye. Like that people will say, our mom will say at home. Okay. So likewise, the organs in a living thing are located in an orderly manner. The components are organized, which means that they fit and work together. For this reason, living things are called as organisms. Okay. So the definition of organism is the components are organized, which means that they fit and work together. For this reason, living things are called as organisms. So living things which are not alive, that is also called as organisms. Okay. You can see here, this is an amoeba. It is an organism. A dog, it is an organism. A plant, it is an organism. And a human, of course, we are also an organism. What can you see here? A penguin at polar region. Where does the penguin live? obviously at the polar region, right? So this is the habitat of penguin. Okay, the habitat of penguin is what? Where? At the polar region, where it can find food and to reside. Okay, what is this? These are the birds. So where does the bird reside? At its own nest in the tree, right? This is the habitat of bird. You can see a catkins here. Where does the catkins grow? It grows in the desert area. So this is the habitat of catkins. You can see here what? A lotus or a lily. Where does it grow? It is seen in pond. So this habitat of lotus, the habitat of the lotus is where? At pond. Okay. And this is the camel. Now tell me the habitat of camel. Yes, desert. Desert is the habitat of camel. So coming to the next. So define habitat. A habitat is a place where an organism makes its home for their food, protection and reproduction. Example, what we had seen? Penguin at polar region, bird at nest, catkins in desert, lotus in pond and camel in desert. So this is called, let us see, living things at our environment. For example, we are dwelling in our house. Along with us, a cat or a dog or a lizard, a spider, an ant, a mosquito will be there. Okay, we might have seen at our house. And in our garden, we may see an earthworm in soil, a banana tree or a coconut tree, or at least a pot with rose plant, a butterfly or sometimes bugs. So just have a look at microorganisms. We had already discussed about organism. Now let us discuss about microorganism. We had seen some of the creatures along with us living, right? With this, there are certain living things which we could not able to see with our naked eyes. Just have a look on the following pictures. This is a type of bacteria called E. coli, a type of fungi called yeast, a type of algae called Chlamydomonas. This is a type of protozoa called amoeba, and the most dangerous virus is called corona here. So what is microorganism? As I had showed in the last slide, these are the microorganisms. Escherichia coli, amoeba, coronavirus, yeast as a fungi, Chlamydomonas as algae, etc. Okay. So these microorganisms also live with us in our environment. But we could not able to see that with our naked eyes. It can be seen only through the microscope. Okay. So these microorganisms are omnipresent. Omnipresent means it will present everywhere, in air, water, soil or inside the body, and also inside the animal's body. Okay. So it is very smaller in size. As I told earlier, it is a microorganism. So it is very, very smaller in size, and it can be seen only through the naked eyes. So it is seen only through the, it can be seen only through the microscope. Okay. So it is active during favorable condition and it is very inactive under the unfavorable condition. Okay. So it is also called as microbes. So microorganisms are otherwise called as microbes. This is a microscope. You can see here in the image, these are the types of microscope. The specimen will be placed underneath here, and it can be viewed through this. Okay, specimen means the sample. Okay, either it may be a water sample, a droplet of water you can place here, or a droplet of soil or contaminated water you can place it here. Soil directly we can't place it here, we have to dilute that, mix with water and filter the soil, and the water alone, contaminated water alone, we can place it here and we can view through the microscope here. So this is a display with, this is the microscope with the, along with the display here. Okay, so a microscope is an instrument used to see objects that are too small to be seen by the naked eye. This is called microscope. And there are types of microbes here. What do you mean by microbes? Microbes are always called as what? Microorganisms. Okay, there are five types: virus, bacteria, fungi, algae, protozoa. Okay, let us see one by one. Virus. Virus is made up of genetic material and protein. What is genetic material? DNA or RNA. That is called genetic material. Okay. So this virus is made up of DNA or RNA and protein. Okay. Virus is neither a living nor a non-living. Okay. We could not see, we could not able to see virus directly. It is not considered as living or non-living. It is 10,000 times smaller than bacteria. Okay, it is very smaller than bacteria. It has different shapes. Viruses are have different shapes and types also. A rod shape, a spherical shape, or a helical shape, and still there are cylindrical shape, etc. Okay. If the virus is found outside the cell, it is known as virion. But virus are intracellular only. Virus will be located in a cell. Okay. So it is intracellular. Okay. If it is placed outside the cell, it is called virion. Okay. The study of virus is known as virology. Okay. Discovery of viruses. The scientist named Bergenik coined the name virus, and the meaning of virus is poison. What are the characteristics of virus? As I had told you, it shows the living as well as non-living characters. So that only it is not considered as a living or non-living. Okay. Since the virus is neither living nor non-living, it exhibits both living and non-living characters. The living characters of virus are, number one, to respond to heat, chemical and radiation. Hope most of you might have seen the movie Dasavadaram. In that movie, the hero will search for a moistured place to keep the virus inside a heap of sand, right? He will keep the virus inside the heap of sand, since it may react in the presence of heat or radiation. So at last in the movie, the harmful virus will react with chemical that is sodium present in the ocean, right? We might have seen. So virus will respond to heat, chemical and radiation. It is capable of reproducing only when inside host cell, and hence they are obligate intercellular parasites. Okay, it can't reproduce outside their host cell. Okay, I will show the video later for this. Next is the, here you can see obligate intracellular parasites. Obligate means it is a responsibility. Okay. Intracellular means inside the cell, and parasite means depending or on living on another organism. Okay, so coming to non-living characters, actually virus is not a cell. Okay, virus have no cytoplasm or cell organelles, and it won't carry any metabolism. What are cell organelles? Mitochondria, Golgi bodies, vacuoles, these are called cell organelles. But since it is not a living, we can't predict that is a living thing. There is no cell organelles. It has no cell, okay? And it won't carry metabolism. What are metabolism? Metabolism means respiration, digestion, excretion. These are called metabolism. So at free environment, the viruses are inactive, okay? Once it gets a host cell, it will become an active virus. Okay. It can be crystallized and stored for a very long time. In that movie itself, you can see the virus was stored in a small compact box like thing. Okay. So these are the types of viruses you can see here. Based on its shape, there are different types of viruses. Here are some: bacteriophage, tobacco mosaic virus, influenza virus, and still there are a lot of types of virus. Okay. This bacteriophage virus has complex structure. We can't tell that its exact shape. Okay. It has a tetrahedral head here. So it is a complex structure. Tobacco mosaic virus, it has a helical shaped virus. This is a helical shaped virus. And this influenza virus is a spherical shaped virus. Okay. So this is the video what I asked. I told you that I will show it later. You can see here a reproduction of a bacteriophage virus. Okay. This is the host cell on which the bacteriophage is resting. Okay, so the bacteriophage virus rests on a host cell and injects its DNA. DNA will be here at the head here. Okay, so it will inject the DNA, I mean the genetic material, and the reproduction takes place inside the cell itself. Okay, you may see this now.
Viruses reproduce by injecting their genetic material into a host cell, thereby hijacking the cellular machinery of the cell and forcing it to make copies of the virus instead of what the cell would normally be doing.
So this is how these are the small bacteriophages released. So the host cell, what does happen to the host cell? It blasts, it ruptures, okay? And these bacteriophages are born here, okay? So this is how the bacteriophage virus reproduce. So further more microorganism, we can see it in next class. Now please take down the classwork. Dash is the study of all living things in the universe. Biology. Biology is the study of all living things in the universe. Father of biology is Aristotle. Microorganism is otherwise called as microbes. Dash shows both living and non-living characteristics. Virus. So define organism. What do you know about microorganism? Just write down the points I had given in microorganism slide. What are the types of microorganisms? You have to list out the types of microorganisms: virus, bacteria, fungi, algae, protozoa, etc. Okay. So see you in next class. Thank you.